There are thousands of machines we use in our daily life that are made up of lots of parts that all have different jobs. Take this car for example. It has an engine that powers the car, a fuel tank that stores petrol for the engine to use, and even an exhaust that removes harmful gases that are built up by the engine. If we use a special type of scanner called an X-ray, we can see that, just like a car, the human body is also made up of lots of parts. They're called organs, and they all do different things to keep us alive and well. Ah, X-ray machine, I can never lie to you. You just see right through me. An organ is a structure in the body that has an individual function. There are many different ones in the human body, but the main organs are the brain, heart, lungs, stomach, liver, kidneys, intestines, bladder, and skin. The brain is at the top of the head, and it controls things like your thoughts, actions, and all the other organs. The heart is in the middle of the chest and pumps blood around the body. The lungs are in the chest and allow us to breathe in oxygen from the air and breathe out carbon dioxide from the blood. The stomach is just below the lungs and helps us digest food. The liver is next to the stomach and is a chemical factory that helps you store the stuff you need and get rid of the stuff you don't. The kidneys are just below the stomach and control the water in your body by making urine. The small and large intestines are just below the stomach and absorb important chemicals called nutrients from food. The bladder is just below the intestines and stores urine. And the skin is all over the body and protects all the other organs. Okay, so there's the brain, heart, lungs, stomach, liver, kidneys, intestines, bladder, and skin. Let's play a game. I'm going to show you a job that one of the organs does, and I want you to work out which organ is responsible for it. Which organ pumps blood around the body? If you want, you can pause the video to give yourself more time. The heart pumps blood around the body. Which organ stores urine? The bladder stores urine. Which organ helps us digest food? The stomach helps us digest food. Finally, which organ protects all the other organs? The skin protects all the other organs. The organs don't just work on their own. They team up into different organ systems that all focus on different jobs. The lungs team up with the mouth, nose, and other parts of the body to form the respiratory system. It allows us to breathe in air through the mouth or nose and into the lungs. The lungs then take oxygen from the air and deliver it to the blood, and take away carbon dioxide from the blood for us to breathe out. The stomach teams up with the mouth, intestines, liver, and other parts of the body to form the digestive system. It allows us to swallow food and drink from the mouth and deliver it to the stomach to break down into smaller bits. The bits are then sent to the small intestine and mixed with chemicals from other organs like the liver, allowing them to be broken down even further. After the small intestine absorbs nutrients from the bits of food and drink, they're sent to the large intestine and turned into waste for us to get rid of. Excuse me, a bit of privacy please. Thank you. The heart teams up with the lungs, veins, arteries, and other parts of the body to form the circulatory system. The heart pumps blood out through an artery to the lungs, where it collects oxygen and leaves behind carbon dioxide. A vein then carries the blood back to the heart, and other arteries send it to cells all over the body so it can supply them with oxygen and other nutrients. Did you know that if you took all the blood vessels in the body and laid them out end to end, they would be 100,000 kilometers long, which is over double the distance around the Earth? There are lots of other organ systems in the body as well, like the musculoskeletal system, where things like bones and muscles team up to support the body and allow us to move around. and the immune system, where things like the bladder, bone marrow, and skin team up to protect the body from infection. In the human body, there's no eye in team, although there are two eyes in the sensory nervous system. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the main organs again. There's the brain, heart, lungs, stomach, liver, kidneys, intestines, bladder, and skin. There are some unfortunate situations where a person's organs stop working properly, making them very ill. For example, my lungs and digestive system don't work as well as the average person because I was born with something called cystic fibrosis, or CF, which affects lots of areas of the body. Fortunately, I can reverse some of the effects of CF by taking tablets, doing physiotherapy, and getting lots of exercise. However, not everybody with cystic fibrosis is as lucky as I am. For some people, their organs are too damaged and can't be fixed with medicine. My friend Charles also has CF, but a few years ago, he was one of those unlucky people. Today though, he's doing better than ever. Let's find out how. Hi Charles.
Hi Will, how can I help?
I was wondering if you could tell me the amazing story of what happened to you in 2018.
Yeah, sure. So in 2015, I became very unwell with my cystic fibrosis, and the doctors told me that my lungs were too damaged and couldn't be fixed with medicine. Fortunately, there was one more thing they could do, an organ transplant.
Oh wow, what's a transplant?
Well, because my lungs couldn't be fixed, I had an operation to replace them with lungs from somebody else's body. I had to wait a couple of years to get a match that would work with my body, but when a match was found, they got rid of my old lungs, put my new lungs in, and voila!
And just like that, you started to feel better.
I had to spend a lot of time recovering after the operation, but yeah, my health has turned around completely.
That's amazing! So you say you were given somebody else's lungs. How does that work?
As amazing as organ transplants can be for people like me, they can be very upsetting. If your kidneys stop working and you need a transplant, a donor can give you one of theirs and still be perfectly healthy with just the one they have left. Similarly, you can donate part of your liver and still survive with what's left as well. However, if you need a new heart or set of lungs, just like me, they are given to you by someone who has offered to donate them when they die.
That's very sad. But what a wonderful gift to leave behind.
Oh, absolutely! Did you know that by choosing to donate your organs after you die, you could save the lives of up to 9 people? I'll always be thankful to my donor for making that amazing decision and allowing me to be alive and well. Anyway, I better be off. I'm going for a bike ride to give these lungs a good workout. I'll see you later, Will.
Thanks, Charles. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the main organs one more time. There's the brain, heart, lungs, stomach, liver, kidneys, intestines, bladder, and skin. If you want to keep practicing, download the worksheet in the video description. If you want to learn more about organ donation where you live, including how to become an organ donor, check out the links in the video description. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to learn more science, English, and maths with Will, and let me know what you want to learn next by commenting below or emailing info@learnwithwill.co.uk.